Emodhina. He comes under the control of his devotees because of love. And you have that love, deep love for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So definitely he will give his darshan to you. So don't worry, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will definitely give his darshan. Because he is automatically comes under the control of his devotees because he is Premadhina. So he is basically using this term Premadhina. Remember, Lord Krishna also, Lord Vishnu told Durvasaman the same thing about Ambarish Maharaj. He said, Aham Bhakta Paradhina. So Supreme Lord, because of his compassionate, affectionate nature, he comes under the control of his devotees. So that's why Sarvam Bhattacharya was confident that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will definitely give you darshan. Tathapi kohi ami eko upai ei upai karo prabhu dekhibe jahai. But still, I am giving you one suggestion. Just do this trick. You will definitely get the darshan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Although Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, by nature, he is affectionate to his devotees. He will definitely give you darshan, but he can do one trick. So devotees know the trick, how to drag the attention of Supreme Lord. And that is the speciality of devotees. You know? So what trick he gave to Pratapadra? Ratha yatra dine prabhu shava bhaktaloya ratho agin ritva kari veno premavishta hoya. So he said the ratha yatra dine prabhu. On the day of ratha yatra, shava bhaktaloya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu along with all the devotees, ratho agin ritva kari veno premavishta hoya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will dance in ecstatic mood along with all the devotees on the day of Ratha Yatra. Premaveshe pushpadhyane kurivan pravesh sheikale akale tumi chhadi rajabesh. So that time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, premaveshe out of his ecstatic symptom, ecstatic mood, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will enter into pushpadhyan, flower garden. Sheikale akale tumi chhadi rajabesh. So he is basically saying Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, every year during Ratha Yatra, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to enter into Pushpadhyan, flower garden. That is a special garden for Lord Jagannath's flower. And that is, you can see, in between almost main temple and Gudnicha temple. This is called Jagannath Vallabh Garden nowadays, you know. So Jagannath Vallabh Garden means it's very dear to Lord Jagannath, extremely dear to Lord Jagannath. So, and it's close to what is Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur's birthplace. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to take rest because it's long way to reach Gundicha. So in between, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would take rest. So that time you give up your Rajvesh, the kingly dress, royal dress, and you assume disguise as an ordinary person and go there. Krishna Rasa Panchadhyaya Karite Pathan Akule Jai Mahaprabhu Dharita Charan. And when you go there, you touch the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You massage Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's feet softly because he will be very tired. He will be lying down in ecstatic mood. He will not realize who is touching his feet. And at the same time, while massaging Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's feet, Krishna Rasa Panchadhyaya Kurite Pathan. You should read the fifth chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam, that is from Rasadhyay, from Rasalila's fifth chapter, that is 31st chapter. Now, in the fifth chapter of Rasalila from Srimad Bhagavatam. Baiha gyan nahi shikale Krishna naam shuni alingan karivena tomai vaishnav jani. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that time he will not have external consciousness, and in between when he will hear Krishna naam from your mouth, glories of Krishna sung by gopis, alingan koriven tumai vaishnava jani. He will embrace you. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will embrace you because he will not have external consciousness. By considering you an ordinary Vaishnava, he will embrace you because he will not recognize you are king. So basically, what was the trick suggested by Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya? That you should give up your royal dress, assumed in the form of an ordinary person, ordinary devotee, and Master Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's feet and read the glories of Krishna from Rasa, Rasa Lila. So three things basically, three suggestions he gave. First thing is, if we want to get Mahaprabhu's mercy, we have to give up our kind of, you know, designation, post position. That is the definition of bhakti. Sarvopadi binirmuktam tat paratyena nirmalam. So first suggestion gave by Sarva Bhattacharya was, you should give up your royal dress, because he was attached to his royal dress. And second, he said, you should massage Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's feet. So pada sevan, we should serve practically. Second, we should not be attached to any post position and designation. And second, we should do menial service. And then third is, we should sing the glories of Lord. So three things basically, you know, singing, service, and then free from false pride and designation, one can get the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And here Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is giving guarantee that if you do this, definitely Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will embrace you. You see, is before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he went to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya can, you know, as a favored devotee, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is giving guarantee. Definitely he will give. So that means he knows that what can please Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Ramananda Rai Aji Tomar Premagon Prabhu Agi Kohite Prabhu Firi Gelamon. And then he's saying, in the meantime, you know, why I am so confident that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will embrace you? Because, you know, when Ramananda Rai also went to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and he spoke about you, that you are so, you know, serious about, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you really accepted Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Supreme Lord, you want to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you are desperate, and you are ready to give up your kingly, royal position, everything, just to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, he was, after hearing from Ramananda Rai, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, mind changed. He already became a little soft about you. So, now, you definitely will get mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, see, it's two important things. This King Pratapritra, he personally requested Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and Ramananda Rai when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu personally rejected him. So it's important, you know, before going to Supreme Lord, we should consult with devotees. He consulted devotees, these two devotees, especially Ramananda Rai and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. And now, because he took shelter of devotees, Ramananda Rai and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, because of their, you know, suggestion, because of their mercy, they gave a special trick to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya so that he can, Pratapritra, so that he can get the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So now, you know, next verse he is saying, Shuni Gajapatir Mane Shukho Upajilo Prabhure Milite Ei Mantrana Dhridav Koilo. So after hearing this, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he became soft and about me. So the king Pratapritra, he liked that idea. Yes, I will definitely go. I'll definitely go to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the forest garden. So after that, he was preparing to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Snan jatra kabe have puchilo bhattere bhatta kahe tin din achaye yatrare. So if this incident happened when 3 days before snan jatra, that means 18 days before Ratha Yatra. So 18 days before Ratha Yatra, it happened basically. So 18 days before, he made plan that he will meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and they gave suggestion that you should actually meet on the day of Ratha Yatra. Raja re prabodiha bhatta gela nijalai snan jatra dine prabhur anandaridai. Now that description is coming, that snan jatra came, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very happy. Sam jatra dekhi prabhur hoilo bada shuk ishwarer anabashare pailo bada dukh. So by saying Sam jatra festival, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very happy, but ishwarer anabashare pailo bada dukh. At the same time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very sad, also unhappy, because for the next 15 days Lord Jagannath is not going to give darshan to his devotees. That is called on avasar. On avasar means he will not give darshan to his devotees. There are few reasons. One is, you know, three reasons basically. Three reasons. One is because, you know, devotees of Lord Jagannath, they pour a lot of water on the head of Lord Jagannath, on the body of Lord Jagannath. That's why he gets sick. So he gets fever. So that's why next 15 days devotees, they offer, you know, different types of, you know, prasadam. It's kind of, you know, kind of medicinal prasadam, medicated prasadam. Another reason is, you know, because Ratha Yatra is coming every year, millions of devotees comes to see Lord Jagannath. So Jagannath, after Sanjatra, Jagannath's body color, complexion becomes a little kind of, you know, fade. So they, you know, kind of renovate Lord Jagannath's body. They repaint Lord Jagannath's body and make him very bright and colorful. And the third reason is Lakshmi Devi, you know, she told Lord Jagannath, her husband, she said, my dear husband, you know, for next 1 week, you are going to be with all the residents of Vrindavan, Brajavasis. So I will not get chance, opportunity to serve you. So she requested Lord Jagannath, please allow me this next, you know, 15 days that I should only serve you alone in our personal quarter. No one should be allowed. So in order to fulfill Lakshmi Devi's desire, Lord Jagannath, you know, he performs this first time on avasar. That 15 days, he takes special service from Lakshmi Devi. So that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very unhappy by hearing that Lord Jagannath will not give darshan. But that 15 days, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to go to Alarnath. Gopi bhave virahe prabhu, bakula hoya, alalnathe gela prabhu, shavare chadiya. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he used to spend 15 days every year during Lord Jagannath's first time in Alarnath, that is 15 kilometers away from Lord Jagannath Puri, Jagannath temple. And Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur also used to stay there. He made a temple, his quarter actually, Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur's personal quarter is there. Pache Prabhu Nikat Aila Bhaktagon, Goda Hoite Bhakta Aishe, Koilani Vadan. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all the devotees, they also followed Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they also went to Alarnath temple, that is Lord, you know, Vishnu's deity. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then someone told Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that all the devotees from Bengal, they are coming to Jagannath Puri. You remember every year during Ratha Yatra, all the devotees from Bengal, they would come to Jagannath Puri to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and to attend Lord Jagannath Ratha Yatra. Sarabhauma Nila Chale, Aila Prabhu Laiya, Prabhu Aila, Raja Thai, Kohilan Gia. Sarabhauma Nila Chale, Aila Prabhu Laiya. So Sarabhauma Bhattacharya, then he brought Chaitanya Mahaprabhu back to Nila Chale again after 15 days from Alarnath. Prabhu Aila, Raja Thai, Kohilan Gia. Now this episode is not finished. You remember, King was waiting to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And what was their suggestion? When he can meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu during Ratha Yatra, in between Ratha Yatra. So now Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came back after 15 days. That means one day before, you know, Ratha Yatra, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came back. And Sarvam Bhattacharya, and first he informed King, my dear King, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came back to Jagannath Puri. Because King is desperately waiting to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Hanokale Ailataha Gopinathacharya Rajake Ashirvad Kori Kahe Shuna Bhattacharya. So that time Gopinathacharya came. Rajake Ashirvad Kori Kahe Shuna Bhattacharya. So Gopinathacharya came. Then Sarvam Bhattacharya Gopinathacharya, he gave a special blessings to Sarvam Bhattacharya and King, you know, and he was telling Gopinathacharya came and he gave a special blessings to King and he was telling something. You know, this Gopinathacharya was brother-in-law of Sarvam Bhattacharya. He was childhood friend of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from originally from Navadvip, but he moved to Jagannath Puri and he married Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya's sister. So that's why Gopinath Acharya was Brahman and he was very senior. So that's why he gave special blessings to king and he was speaking to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. What he is saying? Goda hoite Vaishnav ashitechen duishatam Mahaprabhur Bhakta Shab Mahabhagavata. He said, my dear Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, that 200 devotees, almost 200 devotees are coming from Bengal, especially from Mayapur, and all of them are great devotees, exalted devotees. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's dedicated devotees. Narendra Ashiya Shabe Hoilo Vidyaman Tashavare Chahi Basha Prasada Samadha. So they have already reached very close to Jagannath Puri. That is called Narendra Sarovar. Narendra Sarovar is kind of, you can see in the Jagannath Puri itself, from Jagannath Puri temple now, it's kind of, in walking 10 minutes about. Behind that, Jagannath Vallabh Garden is Narendra Sarovar. So every year, even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also, before entering into Jagannath temple, it was actually custom that they would take bath in Narendra Sarovar. Because that is very special in a lake, where they perform what is called Nauka Bihar, boat festival of Lord Jagannath. Lord, he is the presiding deity. So that's why this was custom for all the Bengal devotees, that every year they would come and they would take bath in Narendra Sarovar. And after that, they would come to the Jagannath temple. So Gopinath Acharya is saying, now this is the time that we have to make arrangement for 200 devotees. So it was happening in front of king. But kahin king hard raja kahin padi chaki ami agga divo basha adi je chahibe padi cha shab divo. So he is saying that king saying, I will give order to my servant that he will make arrangements for 200 devotees, the prasad, accommodation, everything. So Gopinath Acharya was very tricky, He could have tell this separately to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, but he told in front of king. When Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was talking to King Pratapadrudra. So it's kind of indirect way to take donation from someone. If you want to take donation from someone, you speak to third party devotee that we have to do this program for. And then when he will hear, he will understand indirectly that he have to make all the arrangements. So king understood that, he said, I will make all the arrangements. Bhatta kahe attalikai karo arohan Gopinath chine sabare karahai darshan. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya then told king that, my dear king, you should actually go to the roof of your building. And Gopinath Acharya, he will brief about all the devotees who came from Bengal. So till this time, King Pratapadrudra was, he was attracted to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was convinced that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Lord. He wanted to meet. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu refused to meet him. But after seeing all the devotees of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from Bengal, his heart totally changed and he became fully convinced that definitely Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Lord. Although he had some little, tinge of kind of doubt about this. But Bhattacharya, therefore, he told, King Pratapadrudra, you should go to the roof of your building, palace, and Gopinath Acharya will show you all the devotees. So it's very important to see devotees. Darshane pavitra karo ei tomar gun. And this is the best example. Simply by seeing devotees from far distance, from the roof of his building, his heart melted. And this is the potency of devotees of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Ami kaho nahi chini chinite man hoy Gopinath Acharya shavare karahai parichay. Then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said, actually I also don't know all the devotees, each and every devotee from Bengal. But since Gopinath is from Bengal, he knows each and every devotee. So he will show each and everyone. He will tell everyone name and he'll introduce. Ato boli tinjan ottalikai chodilo heno kale vaishnav shav nikatailo. By saying this, three of them they went to the roof of the palace. Three of them means Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, King Pratapadrudra, and Gopinath Acharya. They went to see how 200 devotees of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming to Jagannathpuri, entering into the city. Damodar Swarup, Govinda Duijan, Mala Prasad, Loyajai, Jaha, Vaishnavagan. So what they saw first thing is very important, how to welcome devotees. Finally, see, you know, some devotees are coming to our place, to our temple, to our center, to our home. Damodar Swarup. So two devotees, Swarup Damodar and Govinda, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, servant and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, secretary. So that shows, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is, you know, setting example. He didn't send, you know, other devotees, normal devotees. He selected his personal secretary and his personal servant who are taking care of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He says, my taking care is not important, but you go and receive all the Vaishnavas. So that's how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he appointed his own, you know, secretary and servant. So both of them went, and Mala Prasad Laya Jai Jaha Vaishnavan. So they went with, you know, they went with garlands and prasadam for Lord Jagannath. And they, basically, wherever Vaishnavas were there, they were offering garland and prasadam. That is important, you know. So even Prabhupada said, now someone may ask this question, you know, they let them come in first, you know, then let them take rest, you know, wash their, you know, wash themselves properly, then we can offer prasadam. But Prabhupada said, this is Vaishnava culture, Vedic culture. As soon as someone comes to our home, the temple, we should first offer at least something, you know, which we call nowadays a strata. Like, you know, water or juice or something, at least something. Or dry prasadam, something. So they offered garland and prasadam to everyone. Who? Swarup Damodar and Govinda, both of them. प्रथमे ते महाप्रभु पथाई लदुहारे राजा कहे एदुई कौन चिन्हो अमारे सी लाइक आई टोल्ड चैतन्य महाप्रभु हिमसेल्फ ही सेंट दिस टू डिवोटीज इन एडवांस बिफोर एवरीवन केम एंड दिस इज आल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट व्हेन वी गो टू रिसीव समवन वी शुड लाइक इन एडवांस वी शुड नॉट बी लेट व्हेन वी गो टू रिसीव समवन बिफोर हिज अराइवल वी शुड बी रेडी. Sometimes, you know, when devotees comes, you know, last moment, you know, we have to prepare for Midanga, Kartal, Kirtan. We don't know who has garland, who will do Kirtan, who will play Midanga, Kartal. We should have pre-preparation. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, see, we are followed Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He had free plan. Devotees are coming. I have to send two devotees with sufficient garland and prasadam. They should go in advance. It's not that the last moment I will go. Like... I'm just remembering, you know, I mean, it happened many times, you know, 2-3 times it happened with me. Our Guru Maharaj, he came. He is coming from Europe, actually, to Orlando. So I was going to receive him. I was driving. So it's kind of, you know, 1 hour in a distance. But it's actually a long way because in America, you know, you can drive very high fast. So I was going to receive him. Now, I started a little late, you know, like I had 45 minutes on my hand because I used to cover most of the time that 1 hour distance in 45 minutes. So that's why I thought, you know, 45 minutes is sufficient. I will reach definitely. But, you know, it was accurately. And then there was one accident happened in between and the police blocked the road. So I had to take subway, not, you know, highway. So that took another 15 minutes. So I have kind of 30 minutes time. And generally, you know, even on the flight, that was flight arrival time. But coincidentally, that day flight arrived a little early and Guru Maharaj came out and he was calling me like anything. But the problem happened, you know, I didn't see any missed call. So I arrived almost, you know, kind of 10, 15 minutes later. And I saw he was waiting outside. First time it happened and I was so scared because he was waiting outside with the holding bag. And it was so embarrassing, you know. Kind of, you know, and I can't explain this. And he was so upset, you know, when you come to receive someone, you should come beforehand in advance. Why are you late? And I give so many missed calls. What happened? And then he took my phone. Give me your phone. Show me how many calls you received. And fortunately, no call came on my phone. There was some problem, you know, network issues. Then I was coming, you know. So, and one devotee was traveling with me, another devotee from Europe. So he became so upset. He said, you don't have to drive. So while coming back, he said, okay, let him drive. This is another devotee. So he was driving. He didn't even speak to me for 1 hour almost. And then when we are entering into our temple, then he smiled and he says, okay, no, from next time, I'm going to try to come in advance. So you see here, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is teaching and our Acharya is teaching, you know, when you go to receive devotees, they should go in advance. And then King says, who is these two devotees whom Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sent personally to receive devotees? So then Gopinath Acharya will tell about these two devotees, Sarva Damodar and Govinda. We'll discuss that tomorrow. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Srila Prabhupada ki, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki, Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita ki, Gopamanande, Hare Hare.